The training undertaken by Rural Initiative for Community Empowerment Rice West Nile in partnership with Strome Foundation, Community Empowerment for Rural Development, CEFORD and Palm Corps is a three-year program for education, advocacy, counseling and economic empowerment peace project which started in 2021, ending in 2024. In collaboration with Bugema University, the peace program conducted modular directorate of industrial training assessment for the candidates. The Vice Chancellor at Tiambogo University, Professor Eli Katunguka Ruakisaya, presided over the graduation ceremony on Tuesday at Itula Sub-County in Palorenya Refugee Settlement and gave a leeway for the youth to access the job market.
So I want to appeal to you, as you have heard, that we are in this business of skilling and educating the youth so that they can grow. When, once the youth are skilled and they have something to do, they're not going to think about Ubangi, Mairungi and other. No.
The trained youth benefited with funding from Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Norway. The activity contributes to increased economic status and social engagement of the youth. The peace program is designed to empower unemployed refugee and host community youth aged between 20 to 30 years through technical vocational education training, with the overarching goal of enhancing youth economic empowerment in the region. Rolex Aleku, the Monitoring, Evaluation, Accountability and Learning Coordinator with Rice West Nile, challenges the youth to utilize the skills attained and change their lives and communities.
And this guides them now on the path they want to choose when it comes to the skills. And now, based on that, every youth tends to choose what skill is very viable for their community, and also interest comes in, because interest versus viability is what we look at here. And now, after the module assessment, startup kits are given to them in groups. If there's a group of youth who are undergoing baking, they give them startup kits in a group so that they can start the life after.
Out of the initial cohort of 100 youth, 76 individuals comprising of 62 female and 14 male successfully completed the assessments, demonstrating their proficiency and readiness for the workforce.
Responsibility. I have two children. This 15,000, I'll divide it into two. One, I'll buy soap, and then the other, I'll buy food for my children.
They took me 3 months for just doing practical by planting hairs. Now from there, I achieve what they are giving me in the skills. In my community now, I can just plant people.
After completing the 3 months practical, I started my own business.
The project specialist at Strome Foundation, Jolly Akor, says the project empowers the youth to have economic growth at household and community level.
And most importantly, they are empowered to be able to talk, advocate for their rights, but also contribute to decision making, communities, homes, and all that concerns them. And I must say, we have also had very great success stories around that area.
The resident district commissioner of Obongi District, Samuel Hasaka Mpimbaza, is pleased with the approach of skilling the youth, which is in line with the government programs of skilling Ugandans.
It is so great because the skills they have given are very great, and they're going to help in terms of employment activities. These are actually job creators, not job seekers. And I'm a testimony of this.
In 2023, Rice West Nile managed to enroll 100 youth aged 20 to 30 years to undergo comprehensive training in life skill for 3 months, followed by hands-on training using the apprenticeship approach for an additional 3 months. The holistic approach aims to not only enhance their technical skills, but also improve their self-esteem and overall employability. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.